Well, thankfully, most of us have not had the excruciating pain of a cluster headache, which can strike without warning and leave you writhing in agony. But now some good news for sufferers with new treatments to bring relief.
It felt like boiling water had been poured in the top of my head.
They just find it so excruciating, it's the worst pain they've ever had.
A sharp, stabbing pain, like someone driving an ice pick through your eye.
They come with little warning.
I wouldn't want my worst enemy to have one.
Crippling sufferers within minutes.
Oh, God!
Known as cluster headaches, they can strike several times a day and last for up to 3 hours.
It felt like, I don't know, I guess you could say claws on the inside of the face and an ice pick being driven in the back of the eye, or even a nail being driven in the front of the eye.
Rachel Reeves was in her early 20s when she suffered her first attack.
It's like a silent condition that, to look at me, it looks like there's nothing wrong with me. But this is something that I might suffer for life, and it will impact my kids for life. It's not good, it's scary.
Cluster headaches, often referred to as suicide headaches, are said to be one of the most painful conditions a person can suffer. They usually occur on one side of the head with a sharp pain around the eye socket, often radiating down the side of a sufferer's face. During an attack, the eye will often start to water and the lid may droop or swell and the pupil will dilate, while the nose can run or block.
It can happen between 1 and 8 times in a single day.
The cruel condition means the mum of three can be rendered helpless when an attack hits.
First I start to panic. I'll pace the room to begin with. Sometimes I'll crawl out of desperation, just crawl around the room. I'll sit there, I rock back and forth. I'll hit myself. I've headbutt the wall before. It's awful.
Her only relief, pure oxygen.
I'm on 15 litres per minute and I sit on that for about 20 minutes. Within the first minute of being on it, the pain is reduced dramatically.
They'd rather knock the head against the wall just to distract themselves from the pain.
Professor Alessandro Zagami is a neurologist at Sydney's Prince of Wales Hospital. He says sufferers can often go years, even decades, before the rare but debilitating condition is diagnosed.
We believe there's something goes wrong in the part of the brain called the hypothalamus. In fact, that's the part of the brain which controls our sleep-wake cycle, and that's why some people can be woken at exactly the same time every night.
While some are chronic sufferers, others, like David Yanelli, are episodic, meaning he can go months or even years between a bout of attacks.
It's almost very inconspicuous at first, and then within about 2 minutes, that'll turn into a full-blown attack.
While he also suffers from migraines, he says the pain experienced during a cluster attack is much worse.
I'll pace around, I'll grab at my hair if I've got any and try and pull it out. Do things like bang my head against walls.
Every couple of years, David will suffer a bout of clusters. During this time, the home handyman can have up to 6 attacks a day.
If I'm outside a client's house, I'll drive around the corner and just deal with it there.
Like Rachel, he says the best way to relieve the pain is using oxygen. For others like Lincoln Scott, who suffers attacks at the same time every year, a prescription nasal spray offers some relief.
During really bad attacks, I'll get them four times a night.
He says after an attack, sheer exhaustion will often cause him to pass out.
I didn't realise how much stress it puts on the body as well. It can run your immune system down.
This is not a minor condition.
Another preventative treatment also showing some promise is Botox.
We think that there are two mechanisms of action. Number one is that Botox stops the pain fibres releasing the chemicals that they release to tell us that we have pain. And there's a secondary effect of Botox in relieving muscle spasm.
Although he warns it's no miracle cure, Dr. Saul Geffen from Migraine Clinic Australia says a number of his patients have reported an improvement following the procedure.
We do it starting at the eyebrows and working all the way back to the nape of the neck.
While the Botox treatment is still in its early stages, sufferers say what they need now is your understanding.
Don't judge people who come to you with these things and just think, oh, it's just a headache. You never could have imagined a pain like it.
If you suffer from cluster headaches, you can find more information on our website.